Hey guys, welcome back to Sparks and Recreation. We just got back from the race, the 250 lap enduro in Gastonia, North Carolina. Before we get into the video, I just want to say thank you very much to Ellis, my dad, Luke, the kids, Mark from the track, and anybody that we met along the way. This went so far above our expectations that I just want to say thank you. So, on to the video. Welcome back to Sparks and Recreation. We have the RV loaded up, car loaded up, and we're heading to Gastonia, North Carolina. Just outside Charlotte is a speedway called Carolina Speedway. Do our first tank of gas and get on the road. First tank wasn't empty. Holds 55. Alright, we only made it about an hour. We're in Cortland, we're hungry. We got our steer horns. I just caught you breaking your phone. Alright, we got all these people blocked in. Let's go get some food. I guess.
I don't know, I got unadded.
You got unadded? How's that frosty? 12 out of 10. Alright, so Gunland Style came on and Sebastian wants to show us his dance moves. Yeah! Well, we made it to Hazleton and in typical Guile fashion, we blew another tire.
It's pretty wound up, huh?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, it's the next day. It's a brisk 40 degrees. We are in Hazleton, Pennsylvania. About to head to Walmart to get a tire for the trailer. Let's go. About 40 minutes later, we have a tire on. Everything's good to go. Only took 180 to fill it in two different cards. On the road. We have rolled safely into the Virginia Welcome Center. We have about 5 hours left. We hit a few windstorms between last night and this morning and it ripped the roof sail right off the car. Those are half inch bolts that tore right through with washers and everything. So, picked up some bigger washers over at Walmart. We are about to roll up to the track after it's been probably like, what, 14 hours of driving, really?
A million hours. But
you have to pee.
Yeah, we didn't drive at all.
Yeah, we didn't drive. We teleported here.
No,
here's the track.
Alice
is helping me work on making it into an 80 instead of 88, which looks terrible because I started it. She's finishing it, but she's making it pretty. This one is just not going to be pretty because I refuse to ruin this because they don't.
Pretty.
Like, there was already an 88, so we're just going to do black over that so we can peel it off and it's an 8 again. Some of the workers came over and we offered them food and they were like, hey, if you want, we're gonna be here a little while. You guys are welcome. They did not take our food, but instead they said, if you guys want, go in the gate and go hang out and check out the track since you've never seen it. So let's go do that. This track is pretty big. And it's banked. Hell yeah.
We also have 250 laps.
250 laps. Oh, this is awesome. You just break it? The kids found a peanut. They're like, make sure you get the peanut. Oh ooh, boy.
This.
So probably the parking probably is down there. Probably where the cars are gonna be.
They do. There's a lot. You fit a lot of people here. We then worked our way back to the RV, settled in for the night, shared our stories of how we think it's going to go, and then we're up one of the first ones on the track the next morning. Getting ready for tech. I like your setup, babe. But yeah, this is the best way to use the trailer.
Dude, that's what we need. We need a tradition of being able to race.
We're getting like, ready for Valhalla over there.
This wagon's getting 396.
All right, met some more people. Everybody's been super nice. We're on our way into the tech barn here. Get our okay. Thumbs up. They're thinking there are gonna be 100 cars. I know there's at least 80 so far. They're rolling in.
ready?
I am.
What's the track look like?
It looks like a swamp. They just wet it for like 3 hours straight. So hopefully, we have about probably 40 minutes till we take the green. I'm hoping it dries up a little bit. There's one groove that's not a mud pit. So
do you have a plan of attack?
If the car hooks, then I'm going to take off. If I just slop in the mud like everybody else, I'm going to fall back on purpose and just let the track dry, and then I'll pick them off later.
All right. Good luck.
See you. All right, rolling over for the start. They're bringing us out in groups of 20. I'm in like the fourth pack, the front of the fourth pack that'll be going out. So let's get our spot. You'll be seeing out the front from here on out. See you guys.
Thank you.
God damn it. That was only like, what, 50 laps, if that?
Yeah, you were coming out.
If it's just bent, it's not broke. So I gotta find a way to
bend it.
Pull that back out away from the fight.
This right here?
Yeah, see, I'm still connected by this.
Yep.
If we, maybe we can, all right, so the strut is bent up in, so we're trying to pull it out using the trailer.
Got that one in my
head. All right, it's the moment of truth. We'll see.
No.
That's way better than it was.
Yeah.
I should be a little limp.
Oh, yeah. No, you'll do all right.
Fixing stuff. Okay. Oh, good luck, Dad. If you do see this, good luck.
Yeah.
doesn't move too much. I don't know what my voltage is, so hopefully I don't need a battery. Fucking bad.
Alright. About 25 guys out there, so.
Alright, I'll just keep going.
Alright.
I'm sure I'm 30 laps behind a lot of them, but.
31.
Yeah. Alright.
so dirty. Well, we did it. We finished the race. I don't think we've come anywhere close to winning. We might be top 15, maybe.
Heading up to collect the longest haul. And if we pitch it. I don't know if we did top 14. I doubt it, but we'll see. I went to pick up the longest haul money, and there was a second slip waiting for me. I didn't expect it, but when we were so many laps down, we had so many adversities come over with two flat tires. A guy ran over the front of the car. The whole control arm and strut had collapsed in, so the car wasn't even really drivable. And we got 12th, which normally they pay top 10, but somebody ponied up some money, so we got top 12.
We're gonna be able to have pepperoni and bacon on the pizzas on the way now.
Domino's on us tonight.
Wait,
guys.
But what do you got?
Well, I went up thinking I was just gonna get longest haul, and he goes, "Hey, you placed." I'm like, "Placed?" He goes, "Yeah, you got 12th." So
you got 12th place. That's pretty good.
He goes, "Well, I'm pretty sure you're the only guy in the top 15 that was out and crashed for that long with your whole car torn apart." So
true.
Thank you, Uncle Dave. Thank you, Papa. Thank you. There was a bunch of just random people around.
Number 14's crew.
Number 14.
He did great. It was awesome.
Some dude burnt his hand trying to help everybody and stuff. We're all just helping each other. It was awesome.
That's awesome.
All right, so that's the end of Carolina Speedway Adventure. Thanks, guys. Super nice. If we do catch anything exciting on the way home, we'll add it. But this might be the end here.